My dear students, this video is on the explanation of art of condensation from Technical English 2. Now, what is this art of condensation? Condensation is the process where you compress the lengthy paragraph into the short paragraph by removing the unimportant words or sentences. So, when you reach into the professional life, it is very much essential to understand the art of condensation. Because when you are writing a technical proposals or a technical reports, that time you cannot keep on narrating it in the form of a story. You have to be very much accurate enough by providing only the relevant point-to-point information. So that is why learning the art of condensation is very much important. So now we will learn the several types of art of condensation. One of the most important part is precis writing. So now, what is this precis writing? Looking at the word, you might be thinking it is precise, but no, my dear student, it is originated from the French word and it has been pronounced as précis. Prayer, I can see précis. So, what is this précis? Précis is a concise summary of essential points, statements or facts. For example, a lengthy passage is given to y'all and you have to write a précis on it. That means from lengthy passage you need to remove unimportant sentences or words and frame it to a short passage. So converting a lengthy paragraph into the short paragraph. And remember, it is very important that the length of the précis can be from 100 to 200 words maximum. Okay, so the next is summary. What is a summary? So, summary is a brief statement or account of a main points of something. For example, you are writing a book on any of the topic, of your favorite topic. And your book is of 600 pages, but you have to summarize or you have to write a brief in one page. So, that brief what you write in one page about the entire book itself is called as a summary. After summary, the next art of condensation comes is abstract. What is an abstract? An abstract is shorter than summary. The main purpose of abstract is to highlight on the purpose, scope, and significance of your work. Suppose you are working on any project, the main and you are supposed to write an abstract of your project. So that time the main important fact is you have to highlight main on the scope, purpose, and importance of your project. That it's called as an abstract. The next comes is synopsis. What is a synopsis? Synopsis is a brief summary of a major points of your subject. Suppose you are conducting a research and you are supposed to submit synopsis to the university. Now what this synopsis is? The synopsis should include the highlight of your purpose, your scope, and also the method you have adopted to conduct a research. That is called as a synopsis. Similarly, in your engineering field, if you are conducting any, if you are carrying out any project and you are supposed to write a synopsis on your project report, that time the main part what you have to include in your synopsis is firstly a slight description on your topic, then you have to mention the purpose why you're conducting this project, its importance, and also you have to mention what are the methods you are using to carry out these projects, and you can also mention the time frame also, during which time frame, what part of the project you are doing so. So this is called as a synopsis. Then the next comes is paraphrasing. Paraphrasing is the most favorite part of every student, because paraphrasing is the process where you reproduce the author's idea in your own words. That is what every student does in an exam. You read a definition, then you elaborate it in your own words. So paraphrasing is the process where you are describing or you are writing the author's idea into your own words. So these are the few kinds of condensations, art of condensation. So the first one was précis, where you had to shorten the lengthy paragraph into the short paragraph. Then the second one was summary, where you had to summarize the entire topic in one page. Then came the abstract, which was highlighting on the scope, significance, and the purpose of a topic. And then came the synopsis. Synopsis was actually giving the entire detail about the schedule of your project, and also the purpose, and also the methods and all which you adopt. And finally, the paraphrasing, where you had to write the author's idea in your own words. So these are the kinds of art of condensation. Thank you.